Hello and welcome to another video of the IT Career Guide YouTube channel. In today's video, I want to talk about how you can become a cloud engineer. And this is just a high-level set of instructions. There are many ways how you can become a cloud engineer. First of all, for the definition of cloud engineer in this case, we are focusing on the role that would be a typical systems administrator slash systems engineer for an on-prem infrastructure environment. And I will link to a video up here where you can find out what's the difference between a systems administrator and a systems engineer is. We are not talking about a software engineer that could also be a cloud engineer. So we're really talking about the infrastructure, the technology, be it the hardware, the operating system, that's the cloud engineer we're looking at. So first of all, you need to work in IT. You most likely need to have 3 to 5 years of experience to make that move into the cloud. The cloud comes with challenges, and if you're not experienced with what the cloud is, I will link to some resources down below in the description of the video. So a cloud engineer is really somebody who works with, I want to say, the on-prem side, on-premise side of the infrastructure and the cloud-based side of the systems. So, and that could mean managing data replication or data exchange between the on-prem and the cloud side of systems. It could mean migrating data from the on-premise environment into the cloud. So an example here would be Microsoft Exchange, that you move from the server-based Exchange instance to Office 365 in the cloud in Microsoft Azure. So you manage the data migration, you make sure that the services, when you cut the connections and flip everything over, that the services continue without much impact to the end users. So let's say you are an end user, you have a laptop, it's connected with Outlook to Microsoft Exchange. So you need to make sure that during the data migration, A, all the emails and all the calendar entries and tasks get migrated over into Office 365, but you also are responsible for how do you change the connection within Outlook from the on-prem connection to the cloud to Office 365. So you work in data migrations. You could also work just with systems that are being built up from scratch in the cloud. So let's say you work for a company that has Office 365. They do not have SharePoint on-prem, but they want to use SharePoint online. And then you could be the person that builds out SharePoint online. SharePoint is a beast by itself, but when it sits in the cloud, it's very different compared to the SharePoint environment that would sit on a physical server in your data center or server room, whatever you have. So to move into that position of becoming a cloud engineer, I mentioned it before, you need some experience. So to become a cloud engineer, you need some experience, because if you are engineering, building, designing, planning a system for the cloud, you just cannot do this by having moved into IT a year ago. So there's really where the experience is needed that you cannot accelerate. Even with a college degree, yes, you could become a junior cloud engineer, but in general, it requires experience. And if you do not have 3 to 5 years, it's very challenging, and you will have challenges to even get that position. So the best approach would be that, let's assume you work in the help desk for a company, that you talk to the IT manager with your long-term goals, what you have in mind. You can talk to your peers who are potentially cloud managers or systems engineers, and then you try to shadow their work. So when you have a lunch break, and maybe you can arrange for just peeking over the shoulder of one of your peers to learn a little bit. Of course, you want to go through training if you can. You want to study at home. You want to look at these certifications. But really, your best approach in that moment is communicate internally within the company and really get the buy-in. Maybe you get the support, the mentorship from an IT manager or from a peer who is an experienced cloud engineer. So I mentioned the certifications. You want to focus on one or two certifications at that point in time, specifically really focus on, let's say, Amazon AWS or Microsoft Azure or the Google Cloud. So you want to try to really learn the stuff that you use at your current workplace. It's always easier to move between roles where you work compared to finding a new company where you're starting from scratch. So make sure that you match up those certifications to the technology that you are using at work. So sometimes it's also challenging to make that jump right away. So you might have to go and use a step in the middle. So if you are help desk and you want to become a cloud engineer, you might have to take that step of being a systems administrator first, again, build up your experience and then make that step into cloud engineering. You might not have to stay that long to be a systems administrator, but you can then easier transition into the cloud engineering role if you desire to do so. Another great way, if you are having difficulties landing job interviews or your company doesn't use the cloud or they're not interested in having you becoming a cloud engineer, apply for these type of roles at smaller mid-sized companies. They usually need more somebody like a jack of all trades, and it might be easier with your current knowledge and expertise to land one of those roles. And even if it's just 10, 15, 20% of the responsibilities to work in the cloud, it gives you that first step into gain the experience. With that experience, you can grow, and with that growth and knowledge that you build up, you can apply for positions with larger companies. So that puts you then in a better spot. Again, it's a step in the middle, and sometimes that's what it takes if you have lofty goals. Lofty goals are good. You need these type of goals, but you need to figure out how to get there. And if there's no direct line, then take a small detour and work your way towards that direction. If it takes 2 or 3 years, it doesn't matter. You still make money in between, you build up expertise, and maybe there are other opportunities opening up along the way. So do not just feel discouraged because you have to become a systems administrator first, or you have to go to a small mid-sized company and maybe you don't make as much money, but you really have to look at, okay, will it pay off in 2 or 3 years? And that's part of the career planning that I'm re-emphasizing here. Career planning is extremely important. If you don't have a map where you want to go, how do you want to reach your goals? How do you want to get to that senior systems engineering level in this case? So you can tell it's not always a straight line. Sometimes you have to take that little detour. It's not necessarily a bad thing. Just make sure you know which direction you want to go. So cloud engineering, I said earlier, there are quite a few different variances. It could be that you get confused with software engineering. There are different roles in the cloud as well. So when you go towards that direction, just identify really what interests you in the cloud. It's also something that you need to relay in the job interviews. Mm-hmm. And you want to start working towards that you build up the right skill set. So it's very important. Without the right skill set, you might just missing the mark. I mean, if you go on a long journey and you're just 1 degree off, mm-hmm. Well, at the very end of a 5,000 mile journey, you're completely off target. Mm-hmm. So the same thing applies here. Make sure you know what you're signing up for. Mm-hmm. Make sure what you know where you want to end up. So, I hope you liked this video. Please give it a thumbs up if you liked it. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please do so. I appreciate it. And then I hope to see you in my next video. Thank you for watching and have a great day. Bye-bye.